Well, it looks like I have to talk about Kotaku today because they may have actually stolen something from fans. What's up, gamers? DreamcastGuy here, and at any one time, I'm typically playing a couple games at once. There's the things I'm trying to beat to turn into giant review videos, but additionally, there's the stuff I'm just playing purely just for the laughs, for fun, for silliness. And something right now I'm totally addicted to is Super Mario Maker. I mean, honestly, this is a genius game because it manages to combine creation with great gameplay. It is literally endlessly replayable. Well, something that's very interesting about it is that everybody on Twitter is kind of just tweeting out their cool creations. Everybody is just so proud of what they themselves have managed to craft that they just want people to try it, right? That's kind of the gleeful fun of this game. Well, this morning I got on Twitter and I noticed that a lot of people were saying that Chris Kohler actually plagiarized a very famous level. Now, in case you've never heard of him, Chris Kohler is a very, very good writer. I've actually been a fan of his for years and years and years. He published this thing that I consider the absolute best history of Nintendo. He goes in-depth about the art of crafting the original Nintendo levels, and he got all sorts of insider access to Nintendo in order to write this book. Now, the problem begins to arise when we come to the modern sense, though, because he wrote this long ago. Now, in order to pay his bills, he actually works for Kotaku.com, a very controversial publication because, while some of their reporting is absolutely fantastic, some of it's also a little bit skewed. Some of it's a little bit weird or seems to bend the facts. Well, Chris Kohler the other day put out an article that was very, very different because instead of being a big, giant journalistic piece or an investigation, instead, it was simply a Mario Maker level and nothing else. It was just a picture that said the Mario Maker's address. And by putting it in, you got to play a level that was called That Goomba Had a Family. Now, when you start playing it, it's certainly an interesting little twist. It basically asks the question of, what if Mario was the bad guy? What if it's actually the Goombas that are nice and innocent? Not exactly an original concept, but certainly a fun idea. Well, a lot of people are actually saying that this is a direct brick-for-brick ripoff of an existing level. So what I decided to do is play through both of them and see if it really is as close as people say, and unfortunately, I do have to say that the similarities are actually kind of shocking. Let's go through both levels at once. I actually recorded all the footage of beating both of them, so let's see what they look like side by side. In both the levels, you start off in a nice, normal-looking Mario level with just a singular item block in front of you. Hitting it gives you a power-up, and then you see a Goomba nearby. In both of them, you kill the Goomba, get a key, and you get to go into this little storybook-styled house, which is kind of funny because, also, both of these houses are very strikingly similar. Now, once you go inside, you see that the fact that Goomba actually had a family, which is very, very sad. As you kill these, it actually plays these audio cues in both of them that basically try to convey the fact that this is bad. It's playing like horror movie sounds, like, oh my god! Now, in both of these, you leave the house and start trying to just go through the rest of Mario's life to try and live a normal existence until eventually you die and go to hell. I mean, it's a little bit shocking, but clearly, in both of these, you do this very long drop into a lava-filled room. Now, it's pretty clear to me that both of these are very, very strikingly similar, and they have very identical setups. Now, if you really just begin to notice them side by side, it's so funny to see how they try and have the same flame torch positioning, they sort of have the same platforming ideas, and they even have things like trying to jump from horizontal moving platforms over gaps. I mean, a lot of this, you can say it's just Mario Maker kind of bleeding over, but to me, it seems like this is a pretty predominant similarity. And of course, both of these sort of end the same way, which is you trying to break out of hell. Both of them, you think you're going to heaven, and in both of them, you actually don't get there. Now, after playing both these levels back-to-back a couple times, in my opinion, it's very, very difficult to think that these aren't, at least somewhat, completely plagiarized. Now, Chris, I think you might see this video. You sort of seem like the guy who might Google himself. I'm not attacking you. I'm not saying that you intentionally stole this, But it does seem, buddy, like you actually played this level at some point. It seems like, maybe if you don't remember it, you beat this level and you're trying to build it again. I mean, the similarities are just so identical that to me, it seems like you, at least subconsciously, understood what this level was. Now, this morning, a lot of people have actually brought this directly to Chris Kohler and asked him to respond to the accusations, and even after all these brick-by-brick analysis things are coming out, his official response is, "Nope, it didn't happen. I just built this level by myself, and it took me several long days." Chris, let me just tell you, I don't think that that response is gonna cut it. I mean, right now I'm actually getting on my Nintendo Switch and looking at the reviews for your level, and let me tell you, most of the comments right now are saying, screw Kotaku, this is stuck, this is the word plagiarism, there's a middle finger that says commie. But see, this is a lot of stuff is that you have to realize that these people are not particularly mad at you. They're trying to defend the Mario Maker community. The thing is, if you try and mirror a level, if you say that you were inspired by it, that's one thing. The big issue is the fact that Kotaku.com is one of the most visited gaming websites on the planet. It's a little bit difficult to try and ignore the monetary aspect of this, which is that by publishing this article, you very likely earned thousands and thousands of dollars. Kotaku has its own advertising that is inlaid in the website. I mean, they are funded completely by clicks. By ripping off a level and putting it on the website and claiming it's a complete article, you are probably garnering a huge amount of money. Now, I think that I do think you should probably give at least part of that to the original creator for actually making this interesting level. And I just want to say real quick, I actually think that the original creator, his level was way, way better. It actually is this real fun thing where at the end, you actually have to jump across the letters, "You killed my son." I think that's really genius. But the other aspect of this that I do think that we need to consider is, Chris, if you did plagiarize this, even unintentionally, if you just played it and accidentally recited it, you need to apologize. Saying you're sorry goes a very long way. Just come out and say, "Hey, I accidentally played this level and I ripped it off. I didn't mean to, I didn't want to, I just think that it happened." I think a lot of us need to realize that part of the reason that the Mario Maker community exists and continually flourishes is because it is so positive. Everybody is constantly trying to lift each other up. Everybody is trying to really share ideas and highlight the most talented and creative people within the entire community. But all of this depends on the good vibes. All of this is built upon people who are willing to work for free, make stuff for free, spend their own free time in order to make all these levels for all of us. You are almost sort of ripping those people off. You're sort of stealing money from the places where money isn't normally generated. If you just do that, if you just acknowledge the fact that you made some mistakes and you hurt a community that's so based on goodwill, it might actually save you. It might actually help you just get out of this mess and maybe you'll be stopped being spammed by clown emojis. I'm just saying, Kotaku already has a very bad rep. They're already considered the crazy games website that publishes absolute bonkers wackiness. If you at least come out in front and say, "Oopsie, I made an oopsie," at least then people will realize something bad happened. Maybe at least show us something like that. Show us a measure of goodwill. That way other people realize that this is something that is just on you. I'm not saying this is going to haunt you forever. In fact, since the internet moves on so quick, people will probably forget this by the time they're done watching this video. But I just want to say, it's messed up if you knowingly did this. Now, I'm not throwing out any specific accusations, but I am just saying hypothetically that if you did play this level, you did think you could get away with it, and you just published it knowing that it was an exact ripoff, well, bud, you might need to take a long look in the mirror. Okay, well, this has just been Max talking about Mario Maker because, honestly, I like the game so much. It is a really good time. If you haven't already, you should watch my review. I'll put a link to it at the end of the video. Thanks so much for watching. What do you think about all this? Does it seem like this really is a beat-for-beat ripoff that was made to get an easy paycheck, or does this seem like it's just an accidental coincidence? Is this just a concept that's so common that somebody could accidentally mimic it unintentionally? Let me know your your thoughts in the comments down below, and tell me what you think of Kotaku down below as well. Thanks so much for watching, gamers. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, share with your friends, and subscribe if you haven't already. But do me the biggest favor of all, and keep dreaming. Hey, I want to do a special thank you here at the end of the video. A lot of you have actually been tweeting me your Mario Maker 2 levels, and they are awesome. Seriously, I've been playing a bunch of them. And also, my buddy is the YouTuber Austin John Plays. He sent me a bunch of levels. I'm going to put his code right here. His stuff is great. Seriously, Austin, you are an insanely good level maker, man. Thanks so much for watching that video. If you want to see something else, you can always click this link to see what I put up last, or, you know, subscribe and see what's coming up next. Also, I promise that whatever I do, it'll try not to suck.